My dear friends, this video is to answer an important question on OBC reservation with related to central government services. The concept of OBC reservation was introduced by Mandal Commission recommendation in 1970s. 1979, Mandal Commission was constituted to study the situation of the socially and educationally backward classes of citizens in India. So Mandal Commission recommended that OBC reservation should be given to these socially and educationally backward class of citizens. 27% of reservation should be given in the central government job according to Mandal Commission. In 1991, the central government introduced this concept of reservation, OBC reservation, reserving 27% of the seats in the central government job to OBC. But in 1992, in a very famous case called as Mandal Commission case, Supreme Court of India introduced the concept of creamy layer. Through this concept of creamy layer, Supreme Court tells the government that the creamy layer in OBC should be identified and they should be removed from the benefits of reservation. So now central government came out with a government order to identify the creamy layer. If you wanted to get OBC reservation, you should come under the category of non-creamy layer. Whether you belong to creamy layer or non-creamy layer is not based on your status, but it is based on your parents' status. So parents' social and educational situations will be the only important criteria to decide the OBC reservation for their children. Who are creamy layer and whose children will not be eligible for OBC reservation, we'll see. So that we will know who are eligible for OBC reservation, those who are called as non-creamy layer. Number one, parents, either father or mother, should not be in constitutional post like President of India, Prime Minister of India, Supreme Court Judge, High Court Judge. So parents should not be in the constitutional post. Number two, if parents are working in the central government or state government, if they are in the government job, father or mother should not become Class A officer before the age of 40. Suppose father and mother became Group B, both should not have become Group B before the age of 40. Either father or mother should not become Group A before 40. If both have become Group B, they should not have become Group B before the age of 40. If father or mother joined as Group B, if they are promoted to Group A, they should not be promoted to Group A before 40. If they have been promoted to Group A after 40 years, their children will avail reservation, OBC reservation. Now, central government is using income test or wealth test to calculate the annual income of the parents to exclude people from the beneficiary of reservation. In this income test, annual income is taken into account by the central government. 1993 GO says annual income of parents should not be more than 1 lakh for 3 consecutive years. Then subsequently, this income limit was increased. In 2004, annual income became 2.5 lakhs. In 2008, it became 4.5 lakhs. In 2013, it became 6 lakhs. And in 2017, it became 8 lakhs. But remember, 8 lakhs annual income calculation, if made, the income from salary and income from agriculture should not be clubbed. This 8 lakh annual income should come from non-salary sources, non-agricultural sources. So remove income from salary, remove income from agriculture. What other sources of income parents are getting, that should not be more than 8 lakhs every year. And when they calculate, they are calculating income based on 3 consecutive years. If in any of the 3 consecutive years, if the income has fallen below 8 lakh, the children of these parents will be eligible for OBC reservation. For example, 2016-17, annual income of parents was, say, 10 lakhs. 2017-18, annual income became 12 lakhs. 2018-19, annual income became 7 lakhs. Then the children of these parents are eligible for reservation. Supposing that parents are in the public sector undertaking. We have to see whether the parent's position can be equated to the central government position, say class A, class B, class C or class D. If this classification can be done, then we have to apply what we have told to central government job children. If this classification is not applicable, then going by the income test, they will be able to decide whether the children of such parents will be eligible for OBC reservation or not. My dear friends, hope the most important doubt you have related to OBC reservation is now clear. We'll see you in another video shortly. Thank you.